Asystole is a term that means no ventricular activity. There will be no discernible electrical activity on an ECG reading. And in most cases, this is a lethal arrhythmia and is rare to survive. So as we look at the monitor, here is what we see on the ECG. Basically, it's just a flat line. So we might ask ourselves the following questions. What is the rhythm? Is the rhythm regular or irregular? And no, there is no rhythm. So we look at the rate. What is the rate? There is no rate and no other rate findings would apply. So we move to the P wave. Are they present? In this case, no, there is no P wave activity, so there isn't a PR interval. Then we move to the QRS complex. Is the QRS interval less than 0.09 seconds? There are no QRS complexes and no other QRS questions would apply. So then we look at our cardiac interpretation. But because there is no myocardial electrical or mechanical activity, there is no pulse and there is no circulation of blood. This is the most commonly seen after a time of unconverted ventricular fibrillation or ventricular tachycardia. And especially in children, hypoxia and shock lead to asystole. The most common reversible causes of asystole can be remembered as the H's and T's. The H's and T's stand for hypothermia, hyper or hypokalemia, hypoxia, hydrogen ions, which equal acidosis, toxins, cardiac tamponade, tension pneumothorax, pulmonary thrombosis, or coronary thrombosis.